half. First thing this morning, the crowd still arriving, waiting for the first match to arrive on court. And, well, much anticipation here in the four pairs in the semi-finals. We've got the world number one pair, and we've got three pairs who have been at world number one. We've also got the bronze medal match this morning, the women's doubles playoff between Russia and Canada. But as you can see, the players are arriving for this first men's doubles match. And Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng are already on court, and just about to join them, Koo Kien Kiat and Tan Boon Hyung. There are the Malaysians, quarterfinalists in 2008, where they were, well, maybe along with Kai and Fu, one of the highly rated, most favourite pairs that year. Fu Haifeng, Kai Yun, certainly as well, number one pair, and world champions here last year. Expected to go for gold. Maybe seeded number eight though, Koo and Tan, but they are growing in confidence. Who's, well, regarded as one of the best in doubles from England. And Jill, this really is a mouth-watering prospect, not just this match, but of course the other semi-final too.
Yes, it really is. And as you say, the fact that all four pairs in the semi-final have at one stage been world number ones, it's absolutely tremendous. But I think the interesting thing here for me is the fact that the Chinese combination, well, they were silver medalists 4 years ago, but China has never won a gold medal in men's doubles badminton. They've won a gold in the other four disciplines, but never in the men's doubles. And they will see this as their last chance. The Chinese pair have openly stated that this will be their last tournament. They'll retire after this. And therefore, this is now or never for them.
Well, the other semi-finals is Chung Jae-sung and Lee Yong-dae take on the Danes, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen. And obviously the winner of this match, and the winner of that, will meet for the gold medal. And as you can see, well, Koo and Tan have lost. They lost to Chung Jae-sung and Lee Yong-dae on Tuesday, 21-16, 21-11. But runners-up in their group, they comfortably came through their quarterfinals. I watched that one against Bodie and Nisara and Maniping Jongjit, and they were pretty impressive. Wins all the way so far for Kai and Fu. And in head-to-head record against their opponents, they have a pretty commanding lead, 9-4. Met pretty recently as well at the Thomas Cup in May. Straight games victory to the Chinese. But there seems to be something a little bit different about Koo and Tan since they've arrived at the Olympics. We noticed it. First of all, let's concentrate on Kai and Fu. Straight games wins. They have been pretty impressive, beating their compatriots there in the quarterfinals.
Yes, it really has been very, very impressive, I have to say. As you can see, all of their matches in two straight games. They certainly haven't overplayed so far this year. They've only played two individual tournaments, reached two finals, winning the Korean Super Series event and beaten finalists at the All England. So everything has been building up towards this particular event as far as the Chinese are concerned.
But touching on the Malaysian pair, I said to you, I watched one of their first matches here this week, Koo and Tan. I said, wow, they look disciplined. They look, you know, like they were confident. But disciplined was the most important word, because they had been pretty ragged in recent months.
Yes, they have. And it's interesting, in the build-up to these Olympic Games, there's been a change in the training regime as we look at their matches so far. And as you've already mentioned, lost out to the now number one pair in the world, Chung and Lee. But as far as training is concerned, instead of training on their own, they've teamed up with the rest of the doubles squad, so they've had no privileges that they used to have. Their previous fitness trainer was sacked and have now been working under the fitness coach of Lee Chong Wei. And we know how fit and fast Lee Chong Wei, the men's singles player from Malaysia, is. And And I have to say, I agree with you. I think the whole of this Olympic competition, they've looked leaner and meaner, and they have looked more focused, and they've been playing better because of it. Tan Kim He on the left as we look at them, and Pang Chia Chang, the two doubles coaches from Malaysia.
Well, he noticed a change as well during the training camp that they had in Bath, Tan Kim He, as the Chinese coaches. As you say, though, this is a real big deal for the Chinese. Obviously, every discipline in badminton is, as is every gold medal they're chasing, but this is the one they haven't won in badminton. The umpire is just about to make the announcements. Christian Johannesson of Denmark is the man in the seat. So we're underway for the men's doubles semi-finals. Malaysia against China. Koo Kin Kiat and Tan Boon Hyung up against Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng, the number one seeds. Tan already on the dive. Lovely placement from the Chinese. 1 point apiece to start here. We got two of the hardest smashers on court. We've got two of the fastest pairs in men's doubles. This could be a real treat, Jill.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, it's both the left-handers who've got particularly hard smashes.
Sorry, Jill, to interrupt you. Talking about a smasher, the Chinese already disputing one of the calls here. And interestingly, I don't think we're going to get a replay on it, because the replays do come up on the big screen as well. Chinese were saying by some margin they got the point given to them, but the umpire must have spotted it. Important, isn't it, for the Malaysians here that they settle into the match fast, because with Kai and Fu, you've got such a relentless pair.
Yes, absolutely. And I think as far as the Malaysians are concerned, it's essential to them that they have confidence. One of the criticisms over the last couple of years or so has been that when they get down in a match, they beat up on themselves, their heads go down, and the lack of confidence and the lack of belief. So it's absolutely imperative they get the good start, and then psychologically they can build on that.
Left by Koo, but fell in. Comfortably as well. Nerves are important as well. Koo was admitting before the quarterfinals he didn't sleep very much on Wednesday night. Just as much nerves in the Chinese camp as well. Good aggression at the net from Koo there.
Yeah, I was saying earlier about the power of the smashes of the two left-handers, and I think with both partnerships we will see the left-hander trying to get to the back of the court as much as possible to use those big smashes. And of course, Koo Kin Kiat and Kai Yun, absolutely superb at the front of the court. So those are their favoured formations, and we'll see them trying to get into those positions on the court as much as possible.
Indonesia and Korea have won men's doubles gold. Here in Malaysia and China, trying to book a place in the final. Thank you.
little nod of approval from the Chinese coaches Zhang Jun and Tian Bingyi. Such a good serve, set up the rally.
And the fact that they've won 9 of the 13 meetings between this pair, the Chinese duo here, it's got to give them real belief for this semi-final.
Yes, absolutely, but more importantly than that, they've won 7 of the last 8 encounters, and I think that statistic is what's really damaging the Malaysians.
Who won at the All England last year, didn't they?
Yep. Yeah, their only victory turns. There's question marks, I think, at the time over the fitness of the Chinese players. Oh, that's brilliant. Chayun at the front of the court. He is so fast, but more importantly to that, he reads the game so well. He always seems to be in the right place at the right time.
Dominant start from Kaiyun and Fu Haifeng. Real work here for Koo and Tan. And just wide from Tan. The confidence between the pair. Exactly 2 years apart in age. They share the same birthday. They're very different personalities, though. Koo the more extrovert, Tan the more laid back. Oh. Didn't fool Koo there, did it? But still dominating at the net. As you've mentioned already, it's been a prominent part of this opening for the Chinese, Kaiyun at the net.
Yes, and I think the only way for the Malaysians to actually counteract this is for them to try and get on the attack first, but at the moment they're not managing to do so.
Yeah, what a start this is for Kaiyun and Fu Haifeng. 10-4 up already in this first game. Sloppy from Tan, and 11-4 is the lead now for China. And already, Li Yongbo pretty happy to take a drink, the head coach of China, and revel in what's a brilliant start for his pair. But for the Malaysians, they've got their work cut out. They need to step it up. Doubles is a wonderful discipline in badminton to watch. It's fast, it's furious, highly skillful. Okay. Foothold in this game right now, Koo and Tan. These are worrying signs.
Well, hopefully that will give them a little bit of confidence.
Olympics, the Chinese pair, and they are looking red hot right now. Four times world champions. craving the Olympic title in their third appearance at the Games. Well, some decent points in the last three for the Malaysians. Bit of hope. Defence, and they managed to turn it around, Jill.
Yes, absolutely, with Kuki and Kiat going forward to the net, and I think that his sheer presence there, he's got to get himself forward. Even if he can't intercept, he's got to be threatening to do so.
Terrific return. That China, of course, have come to gold in this men's doubles in the Olympics at badminton is this Chinese pair, silver medalists 4 years ago, losing to the Indonesian pair of Marcus Kido and Indra Setiawan.
Yes, and sadly that Indonesian pair unable to defend their title here in London because they failed to qualify. They weren't the highest ranked Indonesian pair, although they are now. They're up at number 5 in the world ranking.
Well, I think from a Malaysian perspective, you've got to write off this first game, really. I know it's still 5 more points for the Chinese to cross the line for it, but I think it's a case of building now for the second. Never say never, of course, but...
No, but they do need to play themselves into the match and give themselves some confidence to start again at the start of the second game.
Because they are very much second best at the moment.
Very much so.
Flags, but kind of half-heartedly at the moment. Maybe with a bit more vigour now. Of course, Malaysia have never won a gold medal at the Olympics, and they already have one finalist here in the badminton. Of course, Lee Chong Wei up against another Chinese badminton player in Lin Dan. You can see Koo desperate to get back in the groove. Play from Kaiyun.
Opens up the court with his backhand cross-court net shot, and then the way he controlled that little push on his forehand side from the front of the court, absolutely exquisite.
Well, it's a masterclass, there's no doubt about it. Game points already for Kaiyun and Fu Haifeng. And if there has been a statement to be made in the semi-final, boy, have they made it.
Oh, it's called good.
Well, pretty much sums up that opening game. Nothing going right from the Malaysian point of view, and Kaiyun and Fu Haifeng, well, they couldn't have dreamed for a better start. 21-9, they have taken the first game in this men's doubles semi-final. They have 1 foot already in the final. Not much to be said, is there, really, when they're playing like that?
No, that's right, and in total contrast, you can just about see the Malaysian coaches still offering advice and instruction to their players. While he's battled on, his injury problems, you can see his left ankle heavily strapped.
Heart surgery, didn't he?
Back in 2001, problem with his valves in his heart, and came through that. He's come through heart surgery and then won 4 world titles. It's fairly amazing, isn't it?
Shot at Olympic gold again, but well, that depends on whether Koo and Tan can step it up. I wouldn't call their performance ill-disciplined, really, Koo and Tan. I just think that they just haven't been able to get into their stride at all, and they've been knocked sideways by these two.
Yeah, I think that's the whole point. Tan Yun and Fu Haifeng, I don't think they've allowed them to play their own game. They've just been on top of every shuttle, attacking whenever they can.
Can the Malaysians here make a fight of it? They've taken the first point. Big roar from Koo Kin Kiat. Best rally of the match so far,
without any shadow of a doubt. And it's a rally like that that will give the Malaysians finally some belief. Gone to change his racket. Fu Haifeng ran off court, grabbed a new racket, and they've won the point.
It's gone in. Incredible. It could be a little bit off-putting, I think, for the opponents when you see. There you go. He's off. Fu Haifeng, I'll have another one, please. It's hard to keep your eye on what's going on the court when you see your opponent run off like that.
Yeah. Oh, look how much court. Covered. Got to be acutely aware of what your partner's doing, and opponents have to be acutely aware also.
Now that's better net play from Koo.
Fast at the net, but unfortunately that one, I think, went under the net.
Look at stretching, and look at the eyes of Fu Haifeng there. Such concentration.
And such commitment. I think that's the other thing. He's seeing that point back again. Stretching for every shuttle.
So powerful.
They're playing with an intensity and an urgency that we're not yet seeing with Malaysians. And that, to me, is the big difference. It's not a question of desire, it's a question of application. There's no question the Malaysians want to win this, badly want to win it. Mm. They're just not applying themselves at the moment.
And also the Malaysians have to step it up to a level they haven't really been reaching over the last couple of years, whereas Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng have been at this standard.
Yes.
You know they're capable of it. 2006, 2007 was Koo and Tan's sort of golden age. They won the Asian Games, they won the All England, broke barriers for Malaysia. This is a Chinese pair looking to break barriers for men's doubles Chinese badminton.
Overdone it. But I just thought, as the rally was in progress, how much better and how much quicker the Malaysians were moving in that rally, looking to cover. Koo was moving forward, he could have played that, he would have been going in. I was in the opening game, I felt they'd been outmaneuvered time and time again.
He fell out. Good judgment.
Both the Chinese players were aware that a racket had broken from Fu Haifeng, which is why his partner called for him to move forward and that Dayun himself would move back. Well, the umpire just having a word with Kukian Kiat to say, when you show your fist, don't look at your opponents at the same time. And it's deemed to be an offensive, aggressive move. Whereas if you show your fist to your partner or turn away from your opponents, that's acceptable.
It's pretty commonplace though, isn't it?
Yes.
For it to happen. But
yeah.
Shall I get rid of that fly? Very evenly poised, isn't it, in this second game? Much more so than that first. And the Malaysian pair are ahead now. And we have a match on our hands. I have to say, after watching in the first game, I feared it might be all over pretty quickly. But from a neutral perspective, things are going to get a little tenser. Doubles badminton at its best, but then just a little too nonchalant at the end from Koo. What a rally though.
It was just incredible. Players getting back shots that I thought were winners. But what on earth was Koo Kian Kiat thinking with this final attempt at a cross court? I know that it was a net cord from his opponent, but oh, you used the word nonchalant. You've been kind.
Yeah,
It's a fine margin though. It clipped the top of the net and bounced that. You know, it was close to being magical, wasn't it? Which is what he was trying to produce. And he says that's his character, you know. Some see him as troublesome, arrogant, but that's who he is, he says. And, you know, he's not going to change.
No, and I think that's a very good point, actually, Richard, because, you know, it is his extrovert character and his willingness to try something absolutely extraordinary on court, which no other player would even attempt to do, that has made him so special. So I agree with you on that front, but I guess from a coach's point of view, when you sit and you watch him, and you know, this is an Olympic semi-final, and he looked casual on that shot.
All in this second game. Kai and Fu Haifeng working a little harder here. They're made to work a little harder, that's for sure. Have to say, it's been mentally pretty impressive this second game from Koo and Tan, because they could quite easily have crumbled.
Yeah, I agree with that. The umpire has overruled the line judge and called the low serve as out.
Because Kai and Newman walking off there to be 11-9 up at the interval.
Yeah. Yeah, it was well short.
Has to get into that rectangular box, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Short of the line. So it is 10-0. Good umpiring from Christian Johannesson of Denmark there. Had to be sure himself, but did make the overrule. Now there is the interval. 11-10 to China in the second game.
Has been all from the front of the court. The ability to take the shuttle early and lost in the past. As far as the Chinese are concerned, it's always been Tai Yun's domain. As we've seen in the last couple of return of serves, Fu Haifeng has really improved and got real confidence with a little touch play at the front of the court.
Well, he's got his party hat on. Looking good for the Chinese pair still in this men's double semi-final. Oh, brilliant, desperate badminton from Koo there. And it turns into a winning point for him. And of course his partner Tan. Well, if it's about guts, showed real guts there. Thank you.
Chinese pair hit five smashes directed at Tan Boon-Hyung, and all he did was lift it. And eventually, of course, the Chinese are going to break down his defence. He has to try and turn the shuttle, block it cross court, drive it back.
But it's coming at him at 200 miles an hour.
Yeah, but...
I mean, just getting it back to me is something.
Well, the problem is that if you just keep lifting, you're going to lose the rally anyway. You might as well try and do something different with it.
Yeah, fair enough. What is this, the decisive move from Fu and Kai here?
Well, Malaysian fans will be concerned about this shot from Koo because he was playing that block far too late. Got to be stepping into it.
Haifeng and Kai Yun are the red hot favourites.
Just wide.
Very close this one. Good call.
Character and what you were talking about earlier, Richard, that's where it comes to the fore. Tried something that nobody was expecting on court.
What a return. Five more points to take this Chinese pair into the men's double final. Stakes now for Koo and Tan. And there looks no stopping them. The fastest pair is in men's doubles. They could become the first men's doubles pair to win gold and silver. Fu Haifeng and Kai Yun here, edging closer. Life in the old dogs yet. A couple of excellent points from Malaysia. Still a long way back there, isn't it?
Yeah. couple more points now. And it's going to come down to nerves. Can you handle the pressure?
Two more points required.
Almost afforded himself a little smile there, Jungjun.
Service charge from Belgium, Svensson.
What a time to call it. First service fault in the match.
And the pressure on the time serve.
It's out. Well, I wasn't sure for a moment. I was waiting for the call.
Well, that was desperately close.
And it's match points. How big a call was that? And how big a point?
One saved. Two more to go from a Malaysian point of view. One more point still required for Fu Haifeng and Kai Yun.
It's out. That takes some guts to leave it at match point. So two saved.
Here comes match point number three. This is tense. This is drama.
Fu Haifeng and Kai Yun are in another Olympic final.
Well, it was a fabulous second game after the Chinese pair were far superior in the first. They have a chance to win China their first men's doubles gold. Koo and Tan have managed to go one further than they did in 2008. Can this pair do it now as well, Jill?
Well, the way they played, certainly in that opening game, I mean, I thought they were back to their absolute best that I've ever seen them play. I think the first time they won the world title back in 2006, they were playing faster badminton than I think I've ever seen any men's doubles pair play. And because of injury problems and pacing themselves in recent months, only two previous individual tournaments this year, you know, it's been difficult to judge. But I have to say, the intensity, the speed and the desire shown by these two men have been absolutely full commitment and thoroughly deserved, in all honesty, that win.
Yes, some thought this might be the last time Koo and Tan play together, but I think the way they played in this Olympic game suggests there's still some life in them. But it's Kai Yun and Fu Haifeng who are into the final. It's just a bronze medal playoff to come for the Malaysian pair. Only just over half an hour, but it was a fabulous game to watch, wasn't it? And it took that third match point for Kai and Fu to complete the job.